Changes in matter. Have you ever noticed how many changes are taking place all around you? Test yourself now. See how many changes you can observe. Some changes are very rapid, like the water rushing over this falls, changing constantly and quickly. Other changes are very slow, like the wearing away of this bank. We can see that water has cut away or changed the bank, but we can't actually see the change taking place. This sort of change involves many things. But if we look, we can find more simple changes. It's a bright sun. A hot day. What changes are caused by the heat? Can you think of any? Look at the road. Any changes here? The tar is sticky. There is more tar out above the concrete now than there was this morning when it was cool. You know the heat makes the tar sticky, but why does it bulge out? Let's look further. See how the wires sag between the poles? They are much lower now than they were last winter. Does the heat cause the wires to sag? We can test or experiment to find out. Have you seen this experiment? The pointer is suspended in the middle of a wire which is strung tightly between two poles. Notice how the pointer is swung. How high it hangs. Now let's heat the wire and see what happens. See how the pointer goes down? Heat makes the wire expand and sag. So we can be sure that the sun's heat is making these wires expand and sag. The heat also makes the concrete road expand and the tar expand, forcing the tar up from the joints. Now let's watch the effects of cooling. We can see the pointer rising, showing us that the wire is contracting and again becoming taut. Yes, cooling a solid makes it contract, get smaller. So by observation we have learned that heating makes most solids expand or get larger. Cooling makes most solids contract or get smaller or shorter. Now let's observe further and see what we can find out about how this knowledge is put to work. A bridge made of solids, mostly of metals. Now, what happens to these metals as the weather changes from hot to cold and hot again? They expand and contract. We know then that sometimes the bridge will be slightly longer than at other times. So, here is an expansion joint the engineers have built in so the bridge can expand and contract, but not buckle. Can you think of other examples of the use of this knowledge about the expansion and contraction of solids? What other effects does heat have on materials? Now, the river, of course, is water, a liquid. But last winter, it was frozen over. The water was a solid, ice. The warmth has changed it to a liquid again. This is called a change of state. In the laboratory, we can study this more closely. By heating a solid, ice, and speeding the action in the camera, we can actually see it change into a liquid, water. When the water starts to boil, we can see another change of state. Water, a liquid, changing into water vapor, a gas. Liquid, solid, and gas. We can observe these three states of matter around us. And all around us, matter is changing from one state to another. Yes, all around us, matter is changing. Changing in shape, in form, in state. Any such change is called a physical change because the material itself has not changed. There are other changes going on around us too. A different kind of change. Leaves changing color. Plants growing. Taking food from the air, water, and the earth, and changing it into new growth. A log decaying. What do we know about this kind of change? Let's look once more to the laboratory. Here is a simple experiment. A test tube with a little pipe in the cork at the end. Inside the test tube, a piece of wood. Now let's watch to see what heating does to the wood. The wood is beginning to change. The flame shows us that a gas is being given off as the wood changes. This is not just a change in size or shape or state. In fact, this is no longer wood. This charcoal or carbon is a new material. So this is a chemical change. Heat changed the wood chemically into carbon and gas. So it is that men of science speak of two types of changes in matter. Physical change, such as a change in size or shape, or a change of state in which the material is still the same. Chemical change, when a material is changed to a new material. Why do these changes take place? How do they happen? These are questions you will be asking as you continue your study of changes in matter. Here is a problem for you. This old knife. When it was lost, it looked like this. Bright, shiny, steel blades. Now it is rusty. Is this a physical change, or is it a chemical change? How can you find out?